TJ, the Stereo Bargain File, and I am really pumped up to do this quick review for you all today of the new digital to analog converter. That's right, what we call in the audio world a DAC. And this DAC is built right here in the US of A in California. And all of it's built in America, except I think one part comes from China, and that's it. And they call this little DAC the Modi 3. And I must tell you right now, this is some nice shit. No, I'm not cussing. That is the name of the company. There you have it, so YouTube don't think I'm cussing or anything like that. But anyway, I love this little DAC. It's only $99. That's right. Don't lose your shit just yet, because this DAC comes with the AK4490 Sigma Delta chip. That's right, it's also DC coupled output. You know, you don't hear of that in $99 together. That's normally high-end DACs, you know, costing $300 and up. But anyways, this DAC has three digital inputs. It has one analog output. And so what I want to do right now, I'm going to go ahead and pause it, and I'm going to show you the three digital inputs in the back and what the majority of people will use those three different digital inputs for. And you have one analog output. So hold on for just 1 second. Okay, here we have the back of the DAC. Right here, this first input you see here, that is your power supply. And I'm going to be doing a later review of how to upgrade this power supply. You really don't need to, because the DAC does sound great, but that's later on. Okay, so first one, you got your power supply. Your second, this is your first digital input right here, and that is USB. Most people will use this USB coming out of their computer or coming out of their tablet, and some people may even use that coming out of their phone. Somebody wants to listen to high-res files. Next, you have your second digital input. You have your Toslink fiber optics. Now, a lot of people I've seen here recently have been using that for PlayStations. You know, if they want their PlayStation to even sound better through their amplifier, or let's put it like this, the receiver integrated amp or preamp, they will actually run it to this first from your PlayStation, and then you'll come out of your RCA's analog into your, like I said before, preamp, receiver, integrated amp. But also a lot of people will use this for people that don't have home theater system and just have a two-channel music system that's all analog. What they can do is run this fiber optics Toslink out of their TV. They can run it out of their TV straight into their amplifier with your RCA's analog's output. So, you know, you would actually put your digital in, your analog comes out. Okay, so now we're going to go to the last one. This is your third digital input. This is your coax digital. And a lot of people, like myself, especially me, will use this one to upgrade their CD player, DVD player, or Blu-ray player. What do I mean by that? Well, all three of them come already with a built-in DAC. I'm talking about using your CD player, DVD player, or Blu-ray player to play CD disc, you know, or SACD disc. But anyways, what I'll do, I'll run the digital from the CD player, DVD player, or Blu-ray player into this coax digital. Then I'll run the analog out to a pure analog receiver integrated amp or my preamp. So now that I went over the three digital inputs in the back, but some people may do something completely different. You can see here, we have a little toggle switch that is very, very nice. You can even hear it when I change it. Here, let me get you all a good view. Sorry for all the moving around. So down here on the bottom, that's where your coax digital is. You move up one, that's your Toslink, your fiber optics. You go all the way up, and that is your USB. So I'm going to pause it just real quick, hook this up, because I'm getting ready to do a music review, what I call a music review for you all. But before I do that, I'm going to pause it, and I'm going to give you my full rundown of how I think this little DAC sounds. Okay, I'm back, and now for my ear opinion on this DAC. And I note, I used all audio equipment that I'm very familiar with, so I could distinguish the difference in sound quality. Well, this DAC sounds very, very musical. It has an excellent detailed punch to it. It's full, very full sounding. It's rich sounding. To me, it brought out the background sounds more forward. It has a lot of meat on the bone. Basically, in three words to describe the sound would be detailed clarity with weight. Well, four if you count the width. So that's detailed clarity with weight. So I gave the Modi 3 a 5-star rating at its price point, and I highly recommend this affordable DAC, especially to newcomers of hi-fi, because this DAC is some serious shit at its price point. I shit you not, shit's cheap but sounds expensive. And I just want to say, this DAC, I've heard other DACs, this DAC sounds $300 to $400 DAC, this $99 DAC will compete with. And I'm just going to go ahead and tell you all this now. A lot of audiophiles have been upgrading their power supply. Well, rumor has it that iFi makes an iPowered low noise power supply that's only $49 straight up on Amazon, and you can buy it. It has a very low noise, and if you use that for your 5-volt power instead of the power cord that came with the DAC, is basically a phone charger. But you know, for the money, I'm not complaining about that at all. I'm just saying, if you buy the iFi power supply for $49, they call it the iPower, it will have this DAC sounding even better than it does. And it already sounds great. I mean, it sounds wonderful. I put it up against a lot of stuff that had built-in DACs. All my CD players, all my Blu-ray players, even got one DVD player. This DAC beat out all of them easily. But then we get to my Pioneer Elite high-res amplifier. The amplifier has the built-in DAC. And I will say, I have to admit, that this Schiit Modi 3, it does. It sounds better. But now I'm going to go ahead and get to what I call a music review for you all. So give me just 1 second, and we will start the music review. And until next time, this is TJ, the Stereo Bargainphile. Okay, I'm back. I had the wrong CD in, but here we go. I'm going to be playing for the music review Justin Timberlake and Chris Stapleton, Say Something. This is the best pop duo group performance. So, here we go.
Yeah. heart somewhere. There's melody and harmony for you and me tonight. I hear them call my name. Everybody says, say something.
There you have it, folks. That was Justin Timberlake and Chris Stapleton, Say Something. But anyways, I just want to say one more thing really quick. As I was talking earlier, this little DAC does compete with $300 and $400 DACs just the way it is. But if you want to make it sound like a $500 to $600 DAC, all you got to do is add that i5 power supply. It is low noise DC power supply. I've done got it on ordered, and when I get it, I will do another, what I call, music review at the same volume with the preamp on direct mode, so you're getting a pure DAC sound. Until next time, this is TJ, the Stereo Bargainphile. 5-star rating, baby.